Fine. Now that you've placed the first stone of your building, I'm talking about your trunk, Survivor, we'll move on to the next step in the... Here is what I suggest. Now that you have what you need to make weapons worthy of the name, we'll get down to the serious business. The baseball bats, small bows, and blunt arrows are enough to start off with, as long as there aren't a lot of infected, and they're sluggish. But what will you do when they come running at you, 10 at a time? Yes, you heard right. Some of them can still run. The infection in their nervous system and muscles isn't spreading at the same rate in all of them. What do you expect? They're not all equal, even after death. But the good news is, they can't outrun bullets, and that is the exact objective of your next mission. Find what you need to make your own bullets. Sounds like a hoot, right? I'll give you a few to start you off, but when you get back, you'll have to make your own. I can't do everything for you, can I? Right? You're not saying anything, which must mean you agree. So, to make your own ammo, you need to find gunpowder, of course, as well as other bits and pieces I'll tell you about. The best place to find all that is in any store in town, actually. I love this country. But if I were you, I'd start with the armory on the corner. I doubt there's much left in the way of weapons, unfortunately. But maybe the powder kegs escaped the looting. Who knows?
Thank you.
There you are again, Survivor. Good fishing trip. You'll be able to make your own cartridges in your own armory.
Isn't it a moving experience? A bit like having your first child, but one made of lead.
Above all, it'll be critical for what I have to propose to you.
I can just feel the curiosity oozing out of you.
I'm almost embarrassed at using such tactics. It doesn't matter. I'll let you get fitted out. Come see me when you're ready.
Huh?